Well, friends, how are you? You are very fine. We hope that you must be very fine. Today, this is our English class. We are going to learn a very great lesson of English. The name of the lesson is The Necklace. So normally when we live in a very poor family, we have many desires to fulfill. And basically, much part of India is belongs to middle class family, or we can say not that rich family. And that is why certain desire we have which would never fulfill, and then we have certain desires that I should have those things, those belongings, and if I will not get that, then that particular person remain unsatisfied or unhappy. So similar kind of person is the lady we are going to learn in this lesson, who is looking so pretty, beautiful, she is very smart looking, and but she has married with one of the clerk, and you know very well that the clerk means middle class family, who will in a very difficult way he will manage all these things. So like that her life is, she is living with one of the clerk who as much as possible she is trying to make her very happy, but she is not that happy with him because of the economical condition. So we will see that girl, the name of the girl is Matilda, never become happy because she is not getting that money to spend on or go here and there, have some luxuries at home or have some crockeries. You know that what women need, they need some furnitures in the house, some good crockery in the kitchen, or we can say some good costumes and all these things, and most important thing is that ornament. And suppose they will get all these things, they become very happy. But it was not in her fate, that is why she was very unhappy, and she has almost stopped her life that that I can enjoy in my life. That thing, that particular thought, she has stopped because of her economical condition, as her husband was working in one of the office of board of education as a clerk, and that is why she stopped all these things. And then we will see how, what exactly happened in her life, that we are going to see. So the name of the lesson is The Necklace, from the Footprints Without Feet, this book. The name of the author is by Guy Maupassant. He is the best French story writer. He belongs to French country. Then he was born in the very minor noble family. He is not that rich. He also belongs to very minor noble family. Served as a private in the Franco-German War. He has worked as a private. And if you see his career, at the very initial stage of his career, he has got more impact of his father. So like that, he's the best. Already I told that he's the best French short story writer. His name is there in the English literature for best short story writer in the French literature. Okay, and he has written this particular lesson. We will see there are three characters in this lesson. First is Monsieur Loisel, who is the husband of Matilda. Matilda is a beautiful, pretty woman who is a wife of Loisel. Loisel is working as a clerk in the board of education office. And then Madam Forestier is a rich and who has learned in convent school, and who is the friend of Matilda. Okay, so these are the three main characters in this story. We will see that what exactly happened with the Matilda. We will see. So actually at the beginning, what is given? Matilda is the invited. He is invited to a grand party. She has a beautiful dress but no jewelry. She borrows a necklace from a friend and loses it. What happens next? So already we have taken information about a lady. The name of lady is Matilda, who is looking so superb. She is looking so beautiful, but she is living in very poor condition. So she has almost stopped her living. The way she was thinking in her youngerhood, or we can say when she was about to marry, that time she was thinking something different, but something different has come to her life. But her husband was very good. He was very sentiment person who used to take care of his wife. That we will see. We will see one by one. She was one of those pretty young ladies born as if through an arrow of destiny. Actually, she was a very beautiful woman. That is why she should be born in one of the rich family. That was her destiny. But something happened. There was error in destiny. That is why she has born in one of the poor family, and she has got married with also. She has got married with also one of the poor person. Not that poor, but middle class person. So into family of the clerks, and she had no dowry. Suppose she would have much money to give, then she would have got good husband. Okay, but she has no dowry, no hopes, no means of becoming known. Okay, because everything comes at the cost of money. If you have money, then only you can get all these luxuries, all these things what you desire for. So same thing happened with her. Even though she was looking so beautiful, so charming young lady, but she couldn't marry with one of the richest person, as she has sent money, hasn't enough money to give dowry, and no means of the becoming known, loved and married by a man either rich or distinguished. And that is why all these things were not there, because she was belongs to a very, very poor family. And that is why she allowed herself to marry a petty means very small clerk in office of the board of education. She was simple, but she was unhappy. Okay, she has accepted everything. She was very simple. Okay, I have accepted, this is my life now, because I am not belong to very rich family. So I got the husband who is also not that rich, he is also poor, and she has accepted it. She was very simple. She was, her living was very simple, but she was not happy. She was unhappy in her life. That is the introduction of this character. Okay, we'll see first. Next, she suffered incessantly, miscontinuously feeding herself on for all delicacies and luxuries. She suffered from poverty of her apartment, and that she is thinking about her life, that she should get the delicacies, she should get that luxury of life. But from her apartment, where she lives, that flat has also some sign of poverty. We can see here the shabby walls and the worn chairs. All these things tortured and angered her. And when she see all the time this wall, shabby walls, because suppose you are living in one of the apartment, then you will see that miss not that good apartment, miss overall simple apartment will be like shabby walls or some not that good furniture and all these things. And when she looks that, then she gets tortured by the seeing all this scenario, because her mindset was different. When she was in her youth, her mindset was different, that she should marry with one of the richest person so that she could make her life very beautiful and happy. But she couldn't do that because it was not her not in her destiny. And that is why she was unhappy. And when she looks at shabby walls or a very poor poor apartment or very torn chairs, she get tortured and becomes so unhappy, and she becomes so angry also at a time. When she seated herself for dinner opposite her husband, who uncovered the tureen with the delighted air, saying, "Oh, the good pot pie. I know nothing better than that." She would think of the elegant dinners of shining silvers. She thought of the exquisite food served as the marvelous dishes. And that her thinking, her desire was different. See, when both of them were used to sit together for dinner or lunch, her husband tries to do something innovative for her, but her imagination was different. She wanted some silver crockeries or some dishes, spoon, forks and all these things, and she couldn't get that. She thought of the exquisite, it means very, very powerful, very extremely beautiful food served in the marvelous dishes. She had neither fox nor jewels, nothing. And nothing as there, nothing was there in her family, nothing was there in kitchen. That is why she was upset and she loved only those things. And that is why even her husband will do something for her happiness, but it was not fruitful for him, because whatever he used to show, he used to do, she doesn't get satisfied with that. She didn't get satisfied with that, and she becomes very unhappy, because she wants only, she was willing, she was desired for those only things. She had a rich friend, a schoolmate at the convent, and I already told you, madam, first year was her friend from convent, and she is very rich. She did not like to visit. You know, it is a great question, why we like to visit our friend, because friendship is a great relationship. We can share everything with our friend, but she didn't want to go there. She never desired to go to meet her, because very simple, because she used to compare herself with the Madame Forestier, who was very rich. And when she used to go there, after coming from her house, she used to become so upset, because all the things which she sees at her house, that she couldn't find in her house. That is why she never wished to go. She suffered too much when she returned. After returning home from the Madame Forestier, she become so panic. She suffered a lot. She wept for whole days for despair and disappointment, because in her youth she was thinking something different and she has got something different. That is why one evening her husband returned elated, very happy. He was very happy. Why he was very happy? Because he wanted to give something to her, to his wife, that I got the opportunity to make my wife very happy. And that opportunity he has got. That is why he was very happy. And he has brought something. He in his hand, a large envelope was there. So it was very curious for him that how his wife will react. That was his intention. Here he said, here is something for you. And he said, he has given, and he said that, here is something for you. She quickly drew out a printed card on which were inscribed these words, and she was very happy, because something after many days she has got, her husband has offered her, and that is why she has very immediately, very quickly, she has opened that card. The Minister of the Public Instruction and Madame George Reponieu asked the honor of Mr. and Mrs. Loisel company Monday evening, January 18, at the minister's residence. This was the invitation which was given to this Loisel, Mr. Loisel. Instead of being delighted, as her husband had hoped, actually her husband has hoped that my wife will become so delighted, she will become so happy. But she threw the invitation spitefully upon the table, murmuring. And what she say here? She has threw the invitation card. And she was murmuring something. Actually, her husband was very happy that he could manage something to give her. Now, many days he didn't go out. That is why he wanted to give her something for enjoyment. But as he read that, she threw it on the table and murmured something. What do you suppose I want with that? But my dear, I thought it would make you happy. You never go out, and this is an occasion and a fine one. And he was puzzled. Why? My dear, I thought it would make you happy, because I know that you are living in unhappiness, you are living in not contentment state of mind. So I feel that after seeing this invitation card, you will become so happy. Because many days you haven't gone anywhere, and this is the best occasion, we can go somewhere out. You will meet some people in a luxurious locality. And also he has said that, and fine one, everybody wishes one, and it is very select, not many are given to employees. And this is selected people are going to come in this party. Not many have got this invitation, you have got, we have got this invitation card. And that is why we have to go there. You will see the whole official world there. And from my office top, many those who are very honored people will be there. And I am one of them. So you will enjoy, we all will enjoy that. It is, the party is kept for all selected one, not all for all. He had not thought of that. He stammered. And he had not thought of that. Okay, what do you suppose I have to wear to such a thing as that? And she asked, so okay, we will go there. What do you think? What I will wear? Suppose you are going in one of the, you know, luxurious party. What should I, what you feel that I will wear? And that was a very strange question for him. That is why he stammered. He couldn't say anything because he knew very well that both are not in, belongs to luxurious family. That is why something simple he will wear. Why the dresses you wear when we go to the theater? So those same dress, he said that when she asked, what you suppose that I will wear for this party? Then she say, he said that, okay, the dresses which you wear when we go out for the cinema, when we go out for the market, that dresses you wear. Why the dress you wear when we go out to the theater? It seems very pretty to me. He was silent. It seems very pretty to me. He was silent, then stupefied, stunned in dismay at the sight of his wife weeping. He stammered again because she was disappointed. Okay, you got that, you have provided me that opportunity to go for the party where all people will come, but I will not wear that luxurious dress. And that is why she started weeping. And then again he stammered, again he stopped. He couldn't say anything because his wife was crying. Okay. What's the matter? What's the matter? By a violent effort, she had controlled her vexation, irritation, and responded in a calm voice, weeping her moist cheek. Nothing, only I have no dress, and consequently I can't go to this affair. And what she said, she was crying very bitterly. And what happened? What happened? He was asking her. Her husband, Matilda's husband, was asking, why, what happened, why you are crying? Then much effort she has taken to stop her weeping. And then she said, I don't have that luxurious dress, I can't go for this party. Because I don't want to get humiliated there, okay? I don't want to go there because I may get insulted there because all will tease me, what type of dress you have worn. So that will make me, you know, insulted, feeling insulted. That is why I don't want to go there. Give your car to some colleagues, though whose wife is better fitted out than I. And then she said that, okay, this is not in our luck because we are belongs to a very poor family. I don't have that luxurious dress and everything. That is why I am not fitted there. So you can give that invitation card to one of your colleagues. Whose wife can suited or fitted there more than me, she said. He was grieved, he was very unhappy, but answered, let's see, Matilda, how much would a suitable costume cost, something that would serve for other occasion, something very simple. And then he thought that, okay, this is the problem, the dress is the problem, okay, I will solve the problem. Let's see, so say, how much cost will be of the dress which you want to wear or which can be wear in such type of parties. She said. She reflected for some second, thinking of a sum that she could ask for without bringing with it an immediate refusal and a frightened exclamation for the economical clerk. And she thought for a while that what she will say, what type of sum she will say, because she knows very well the condition, economical condition of her husband, the person who is clerk in one of the education board office, okay. So she was thinking, what should I say? And she was thinking that, and maybe suppose I will tell more higher price, then he will become shocked. My God, that much. That is why she has taken some pause there. Finally, she said in a hesitating voice, I can't tell exactly how much amount will be there to purchase one fine dress. But it seems to me that 400 francs ought to cover it. So she said approximately or less or more, around 400 francs will be there. He turned a little pale because it was big budget for him, because he is a clerk and clerks cannot afford that. That he becomes so pale, for he had saved just his sum, the same sum, to buy a gun that he might be able to join some hunting parties the next summer with some friends who went to shoot larks on Sunday. Nevertheless, he answered, "Very well, I will give you 400 francs, but try to have rich dress." Then she said that that will be around 400 francs. And when he heard that amount, he becomes so pale. Oh my God, 400 francs, my God. And then exactly the same amount he has, stored. He has stored in his pocket money. And actually his willingness was that to purchase one gun, and he wanted to go for shooting, go for hunting with his friend. And he said, okay, fine, I will not go for that summer hunting. I will use it for my wife's delightment. And then he said, okay, fine, no problem, you can purchase. I will give you 400 francs and you have to purchase that dress. But select very fine, which will make you very happy. The day of the ball approached, and Madame Loisel seemed sad, disturbed, anxious. Now he has given the dress, but day of the ball, means that particular party, has approaches very quickly near. But she was looking so unhappy, she was looking so tortured, or we can say unsatisfied, very anxious and disturbed. Nevertheless, her dress was nearly ready, and already he had given money to purchase dress, and the dress also was ready. Her husband said to her one evening, "What is the matter with you? You have acted strangely for 2 or 3 days. Last 3 or 4 days I have seen you, but you are looking little strange. You are behaving little strange. Now you have got a dress." And she responded, "I am vexed not to have a jewel, nothing to adorn myself with. I don't mean decorate." And she has expressed her agony that, okay, I have the dress, but now I don't have that jewels which will adorn me, which will decorate me. You know that this is a very fantastic idea of the women, that they want ornament, and without ornament they can't go out. Nowadays in modern era, if you see girls, they don't wear bangles, they don't have any necklace and all. But suppose if we go a decade ago, then we can see that ornament, even though now, suppose we are going in one of the festival or one of the religious festival, we see that most of the women wear a different ornament, which is a token of their status. So she warned that, and see what she said to her husband, that I don't have jewels, and without jewels I can't decorate myself. I can't be that effective, highly effective in that particular party. I shall have such a power, poverty-stricken look. If I will not have that jewel, then I will look like a very poor woman in that party. I would prefer not to go this party. And if I will not have that jewel or ornament, then I will not go to the party. She said, it is fixed and final. I will not go to the party because I will not have that dress. And what is the use to look like a poor young lady in that party and become the stock of joke for others? He replied, "You can wear some natural flowers. In the season, they look very chic." So he had certain ideas. He said that, okay, if you don't have any jewel, you can wear some certain flowers. Okay, some flowers in this particular atmosphere, it looks so good. And if you wear that, it will be more, natural, we can see that. She was not convinced. "No," she replied, "there is nothing more humiliating than to have a shabby air in the midst of the rich women." And she said that it will be humiliating. Suppose I will go without jewel in the the particular company of the rich women, it will not be suited for me. And if I will go there, it will be insulting for me. So I will not go there, she said that. She uttered then her husband cried out, "How stupid we are. Go and find your friend, Madame Forestier, and ask her to lend you her jewels." And then again, one idea was that she should use some natural flowers. She said no, that idea is rejected by her. Then she said, "Okay, oh my God, how stupid we all are. We can go, you can go to your go to your friend, Madame Forestier, and lend one of the jewels, or we can say one of the ornament from her. She uttered a cry of joy. "It's true," she said. "I had not thought of that." The next day she took herself to her friend's house and related her story of the distress. And she said that, "Okay, I have got an invitation and I need to go to the party, but I have dress now, but I don't have that ornament. And if you will give me, then I can go there in the party." The Madame Forrester went to her closet, took out a large jewel case, brought it, opened it and said, "Choose, my dear, whatever you want, choose it and wear it. You are my friend, and if you want that, you can choose one of them." And she went to the closet, she went to her cupboard, and she has taken out one of the big box, and she has put her forward, "Take it." Then she saw at first some bracelet, then a collar of the purse, then a ventian, then cross of gold and jewels and admirable workmanship. She tried the jewels before the glass, hesitated, but could neither decide to take them nor leave them. And many type of ornaments she has seen. She has wore it, she has worn it, and she put herself in front of mirror and she said no. Then again she kept there. She couldn't choose also and she couldn't reject also, because after many days she has got such type of situation or opportunity to wear some jewels. You know that suppose we go in one of the shop for shopping, then we have to choose one, then it is most difficult thing. And same thing happened with her, that she wanted to choose one of the best, okay, the best ornament which will suit her. And that is why she was just trying to catch many ornament, but she couldn't. And she couldn't even reject also any ornament. That is why. Then she asked, "Have you nothing more?" "Why, yes, look for yourself. I do not know what will please you." And she said that, "Okay, many ornaments you have seen, but you do not looking so fine. You are not looking so happy. So I don't know which ornament will please you. So, okay, I have more." And she went inside, and suddenly she discovered in the black satin box a superb necklace of the diamonds. Her hands trembled as she took it out. She placed it about her throat against her dress and was ecstatic. Then she, very, very joyful, then she asked in a voice full of anxiety, "Could you lend me this? Only this?" "Why, yes, certainly." And then she, one of the diamond necklace she has brought, Madame Postier, who is her convent friend, rich convent friend, has brought one diamond necklace. And when she has seen that diamond necklace, she looks so happy as she has taken it. She has put it around her neck and she asked, "Could you lend me this? Please, could you lend me this?" They say, "Why not? You can lend it. You can take it." And she fell upon the neck of her friend, embarrassed her with the passion. Then she then went away with her treasure. And then afterwards, she said, "Yeah, okay, fine, no problem. We can take it." Then she fell upon the neck of her friend, and then she shows some affection towards her friend, and embarrassed her. She hugged her with the passion. Then she went upon the treasure. The day of the ball arrived. Madame Loisel was a great success. She was turned was prettiest of all. And when she has worn such type of very delicate dress, very beautiful dress, and again, moreover, she has worn that diamond necklace. So she was looking the prettiest woman. Okay, see, elegant, gracious, smiling, and full of joy, because very, you know, few opportunities got in her life to become so happy. And that is why after many years, she has got that opportunity. That is why she becomes so happy. She was looking so joyful there. And all the men noticed her because she was looking so gorgeous. She was looking so pretty. She was looking so beautiful. That is why all were looking at her. "Wow, you are looking so good," and like that. She was all were noticing her and asked her name, "What is your name?" and wanted to be presented, wanted to ask her, wanted to talk with her. And that much she has got the appreciation by the look, by the gesture of the people. Till we will stop. So we have seen that Matilda belongs to a very poor family, and she got married with one of the middle class family, one person, that is Loisel, Mr. Loisel, who is a clerk in the board office, okay, education board office. And Matilda is a very beautiful woman. She wanted to marry with one of the rich person, but she couldn't because she didn't have a dowry to give. That is why she couldn't get. And she was not unhappy, but she was very unhappy. She was living very simple, but very unhappy. And also she don't want to go to her friend, Madam Forestier, because after coming from her home, she used to become so tortured because she get the things which she desire for. Then afterwards, one day, her husband has brought one invitation card that he said that this is the invitation card and we have to go to the party, ball party. But she becomes so unhappy. Why? Because she said that I don't have a dress, and if I will go in the dress which you said, I will be humiliated in the party. That is why he asked me how much amount will be there for the party, that particular dress. Then she said, after much thinking, she said that it will be around 400 francs. Then whatever money he has stored to go for the hunting in summer for his pleasure. But he said, okay, I will not go for my pleasure, I will not go, but I will make my wife very happy. And he had given around 400 francs to her. As that ball day or that party day was approaching to us very near, but Matilda was not happy. Then one day, Miss Loisel asked, why you are looking so disturbed and irritated and not looking so anxious? Then she said that I don't have jewels, and without jewels, if I will go, I will become so very poor, and that is why I can't go in the party. Then he said that, okay, you can use some natural flowers that will be neatly suit on you. She said, no, I will not go. It will look, all will insult me. Then he said that, okay, why don't you go to your friend's house, Forestier, Mrs. Forestier, who is a rich person, who is a rich lady. Then she said, okay, fine, I will go there. And as soon as she goes there and she asks for the ornament, then she find many ornament bracelet and many things. She couldn't check. But when she gave gold necklace, black necklace, then black diamond necklace, she becomes so happy. And then she goes there, and all, she was looking so pretty, so beautiful. That is why all were noticing her. So till we have learned, I hope that you have understood it. Thank you. Thank you very much.